Hello everyone, my name is Khushbu Pargil. I am a third year radiology resident in Siusha Medical College. I would like to thank Harshad sir, Nirmala ma'am and Rashesh sir for their constant guidance and support. I am presenting a case of 8 years old female patient with complaints of fever with vomiting since 7 days, doubling of vision since 6 days and occasional headaches. Patient had no complaint of convulsions or any other neurological symptoms. MRI brain study revealed altered signal intensity lesion in right lateral ventricle, which appeared hypointense on T1 weighted images, hyperintense on T2 weighted images, and hypointense on flare images. On coronal image, we can see that the lesion is involving right lateral ventricle, arising at the foramen of Monroe. Medially, the lesion is abutting the septum pellucidum and the lesion is causing mild obstructive hydrocephalus. There is ipsilateral dilatation of right lateral ventricle, which is suggestive of intraventricular location of the lesion. Diffusion-weighted images do not show any restricted diffusion. GRE images do not show any blooming to suggest any calcification or hemorrhage. Post-contrast images do not reveal any contrast enhancement. So far what we know is the lesion is well-defined, intraventricular in location, it is non-enhancing, does not show any calcification or hemorrhage, does not show any brain edema, it appears to be low-grade in nature. Let's have a look at the approach now. We know that the lesion is tumoral in origin. So, possibilities of non-tumoral etiologies like infectious process, cystic lesion, normal variant of CSF space appears less likely. We also know that the patient does not have any intraparenchymal lesion and brain edema. Patient is young and does not have any primary malignant tumor. So, possibility of secondary also appears less likely. So now these are the differentials we have. Choroid plexus papilloma are lobulated, they are very vascular and demonstrates avid enhancement, so they appear less likely. Central neurocytoma are bubbly in appearance, having multiple cystic lesion and flow voids. They show moderate to strong contrast enhancement, so they also appear less likely. Ependymoma are cystic components having small chunky calcification and heterogeneous enhancement, they also appear less likely. Subependymal giant cell astrocytoma appears less likely as they are periventricular in location and they are often associated with tuberous sclerosis. It can't be a meningioma as patient is a child and lesion does not enhance. So we are left with two possibilities. I would like to put first possibility of intraventricular pilocytic astrocytoma as they have a variable appearance on MRI, and second possibility of subependymoma. Although only 18% of subependymoma are seen in young patients, MRI appearance is similar to the subependymoma. Patient went under neurological resection of the tumor and biopsy report suggested that the lesion was pilocytic astrocytoma. Pilocytic astrocytomas are known as juvenile pilocytic astrocytomas. They are considered WHO grade 1 tumors. They are low grade, relatively well defined astrocytomas that tend to occur in the first 2 decades of life with a peak incidence between 8 to 13 years of age. They are most common primary tumors of brain and 15% of all pediatric brain tumors. Most common location is cerebellum. 60%. Second most common location is along the optic pathway. They are often associated with neurofibromatosis type 1. Other less common locations are cerebral ventricles and spinal cord. There was one study conducted by Department of Neurology, All India Institute of Medical Sciences, New Delhi. From January 2010 to August 2015, and 8 patients were histopathologically proven intraventricular pilocytic astrocytoma were encountered. Their conclusion was, it is of rare occurrence. Almost all patients presented with headache progressive loss of vision. They are difficult to diagnose in the pre-operative period only based on the radiological profile. These tumors are extremely vascular and extensive calcification is seen. Pre-operative radiological diagnosis by keeping a high index of suspicion can help in better operative planning, reducing blood loss and improving post-operative outcomes. So take-home message is, almost all patients with intraventricular pilocytic astrocytoma presented with headache and progressive loss of vision. Most of these tumors can be associated with extensive calcification. They show variable post-contrast enhancement from none to avid. These are difficult to diagnose in the pre-operative period based only on the radiological profile, but important to diagnose due to its tendency to bleed. Thank you.